Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. Welcome to the Mental House. With me, your host, Family Khadija. This comment that I know that is a very controversial subject, and I just have to touch on it. Because these are the things that bothered me while I was on my little hiatus and trying to spend quality time with my Zuri. While he's, I'm just trying to spend as much time with him as possible and trying to take care of a little business. So I've been busy, and I also been out trying to gather information from NAMNI, and which is the National Alliance for the Mentally Ill. And hoping that I'll be able to do some broadcasts with them for later up on coming up. So I just got a few things in the works, and as soon as I begin to understand how to do this live stream without making an ass out of myself, I'm just gonna go for it. But what was on my mind and what I really had to talk about had nothing to do with that. It had to really do with Monique. And I waited a while before I made a comment on this because I love Monique and I love Sydney. And I just think, I mean, they're okay with me in terms of, I mean, I don't know them personally. I like what they represent. And I know that for some people that's a problem. You know, the truth will make us free. You know? And it's amazing to me how less that we think of ourselves. But then every time I pull out the Willie Lynch letter and I look at it and I think about that paragraph, it just really pierced my soul when I look at that paragraph when Willie Lynch says, "Gentlemen, you know what your problems are. I do not need to elaborate. I'm not here to enumerate your problems. I am here to introduce you to a method of solving them. In my bag, I have a foolproof method of controlling your black slaves. I guarantee you that every one of them, if installed correctly, it will control the slaves for at least 300 years. At least, whether you believe Willie Lynch is a fictional character, you know, most of us know by now that he is. It really doesn't really matter, does it? I mean, because it's like, don't cut off your nose to spite your face. Who gives a damn if the person is real or not? You need to be thinking about if what he says has created the state of mind, the state of dependency that we're in today. You know, especially when he says that you must also have your white servants and your overseers distrust all blacks. It is necessary that your slaves trust and depend on us. They must love, respect, and trust only us. Gentlemen, these are the keys to control. Use them. Have your wives and children use them. Never miss an opportunity. If used intensely for 1 year, the slaves themselves will remain perpetually distrustful of each other. You know, and again, whether Willie Lynch is a real character or not, it doesn't really matter. Those lines, that those phrases stick in my mind. Because when I think about Monique, it's amazing to me how everybody had comments about how much of a liar that she was. How she was rocking a boat, how Lee stopped talking all that, you know, unequality stuff, and you would think us being descendants and children of slaves that we would know. See how capitalism has destroyed us all? It has destroyed our ability to even stand up for one another. It has destroyed our ability to even think rationally. That's why y'all can get mad at me all damn day long. Somebody said, do black lives matter? I said, sometimes, just like Jamal Bryant. Sometimes black lives matter. And the sometimes is when other folks kill us. That's when our lives matter. As long as we doing ourselves, as long as we disrespecting, making fun of, how dare us? Every one of those people and persons that call Monique a liar, she put the receipts out there. And then you say, well, I don't want to read all that. That's too long. That's word salad. Well, what the hell are you calling her a liar for? See what I mean by these ADHD babies? What, you can't even read it. What she said. She's getting you the receipts. I don't care if all the players are black. She explained in detail and showed receipts about the John liar guy, the and then gave the guy an ultimatum. Said, you prove I'll get out of show business if you prove what I'm saying to be wrong. So far, I haven't heard back from this dude. She said, now, will you get out of show business if what you're saying is a lie? But guess what? Y'all ain't gonna stick by her. Even if you didn't agree. I'm not saying everybody gotta agree with Monique. But you should all know injustice, and y'all all know y'all been given the bad end of the stick. You all know that in terms of money. Hell, they stole our inheritance. And if you ain't got nothing good to say about it, I'm not even saying you gotta agree with it. Maybe you should not have said nothing at all. But to let the enemy know, black or white, that's the enemy. Doesn't matter. The hate move. To let them know that you're making fun of her, and you think it's funny, and you think she's a joke, that to me, very disheartening. So I waited a while before I made a comment about Monique and Sydney in the situation. And I wish them the best. I'm not trying to tell them. People don't know what these contracts consist of. I know. You know, I heard somebody say, oh, she could have took that money and flipped it and could have did this with it. And she needs some dope boys and they can do that. I mean, you know. Wow, y'all. Wow. Okay. See, y'all wouldn't think like that. And that's because you don't have any black politics. It make you settle for shit like that. Make you even think like a victim. Like the pain body that your cell represent. And instead of y'all trying to purge yourself of these pain victimized bodies, you would rather go against the grain and go against your sister, go against that woman who you know she's telling the truth about the inequality that exists. And the fact that Amy Schumer, who stole all her jokes pretty much from Patrice O'Neill, I ain't gonna say all of them, but quite a few. I've heard a few. And she's not particularly funny to me. But y'all talk shit about Monique. Wow. Wow. That's deep. And it's these kind of actions that when you listen to these idiots on the talking about black people have to unite and this type of stuff, that's why it goes in one ear and come out the other. Because we have been too damaged. Too damaged. Too damaged. I'm like Neely Fuller. When you look at me now, I'm not very optimistic about black people at all. In fact, I'm pretty pessimistic. See, because I know black politics work on a local level. I know it works. I've been a part of it. I was a part of the first father-son automatic team in the history of America. We put them both in office. Black politics does work. And when you have black politics, you have equality. You have equality. Because we don't have no respect. Hell, we don't even respect ourselves. Black lives don't matter. Black lives ain't shit. Not even to us. It only matters when somebody else is killing us. Not when we kill ourselves. Black lives don't matter then. And if y'all think I'm all over the place, just tie it all in together. It'll still equal one. Peace, Sister Monique. I'm out of here, y'all. If you like what you hear, please like, subscribe, and share. I'll be back a little later, right here in the mental house. Bye-bye.